Comedy Wednesday.
Some of the greatest guitarists in the world have described him as a prodigy, but to those who know him better, Nathan Cavaleri is also a bit of a hero. His rise to the big time at the tender age of 10 hasn't been as meteoric as it sounds. In fact, it's been a battle for survival, but the battle is now won, and Nathan's set to take on the musical stages of the world, and there's a movie part coming. Carmel Travis caught up with Nathan at a very special gig.
Well, I'm shooting a movie in December. I'll be doing something in September. I think I'm going to do some blues festivals. I'm not sure what else we've got planned. Actually, I'm going to Queensland.
Nathan Cavaleri. He's 10. He's a guitarist. He's also just released a new album, Jamming with the Cats.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Anyway, this song's called Josh's Boogie, and I wrote it for my 6-year-old brother, Josh.
Okay, let's go.
Professional.
He's jammed with the greats, Mark Knopfler of Dire Straits.
That was pretty fun jamming with Mark Knopfler.
And on stage with his old mate, Jimmy Barnes. He's here at Radio Lollipop and the Starlight Express Room of the Camperdown Children's Hospital. He's here to put into place one part of his life he hopes might be over. Nathan Cavaleri, cancer kid.
I've been in this hospital and I know what it's like.
3 years ago, Nathan's leukemia was diagnosed. After a 2-year rollercoaster ride of pain, fear, chemotherapy and eventual relief, he's now been in remission for a year.
Yeah, I was sort of scared. My disease was leukemia ALL, and a few people have died of it, and that's why I was scared, like as if I'm going to die or something. But I worked through it pretty good. And I still come back here every now and again for a finger prick. So it's going pretty good.
These days, this may be one of Nathan's smallest audiences, but close to his most important. As Mum Joanne says, her boy comes back to this hospital with a profound message. There is life after cancer. There is life during cancer.
The first bit is the worst bit. The way I got leukemia is I had pains all in my back and I found it hard to breathe. I got in hospital and they fixed me up and repaired me and gave me new tires and... In the hospital I played my acoustic guitar and I couldn't play electric because like...
They wouldn't let you bring it
out. So it took my mind off all the pain. So, whoever's like, if you're sick in hospital, it's really good to do something that you really like, and it just, you forget about it, and your pain stops. It's just, it's amazing how it works.
Nathan has something I think that nobody else his age seems to have that I've seen, and that's heart. This guy plays from the soul. Anyway, so it's time to rock and roll. So, Nathan, you take it away.
While there's no doubt Nathan's guitar provided comfort during his painful years as a leukemia patient, connecting the two events is just too trite for this young kid. He was going to be a guitar player come what may. He knew it, his family knew it, from when he was 3. Thomas the Tank Engine didn't stand a chance against B.B. King, Albert Collins and Stevie Ray Vaughan.
People say that you really just feel your way around a guitar.
Yeah, it's like sort of like playing blind. You know how on Star Wars where he goes blind and he tries to hit that thing? Yeah. It's sort of like that. You know where to go when your eyes are eyes are closed or something, so it automatically comes to you. And you think of all the blues guitarists and how they play like this and all that.
So you surprise yourself sometimes?
Yeah, it's just amazing.
The thing that's taken everyone's breath away is just how much at home with the limelight is Nathan Cavaleri.
Well, I'm not shy. What I'm doing now, I've always wanted to do it. I've wanted to do this for ages, and now I'm doing it.
And all this without a hint of young Nathan becoming stage brat.
Please welcome back to the stage, Nathan Cavaleri.
His innocence is a delight, his smile infectious. He's a class act.
Good to see you.
Pretty bad when you have to bring my milk, right?
Yes, that's right. Well, just to make sure you're on the right level, as a matter of fact...
Now the world is about to discover Nathan's talents. He'll star in a movie to be shot in America during school holidays, of course.
Well, I haven't got the script and who's going to be in it and everything and all the names, but I know roughly what it's about. It's about this band that went downhill because of drugs, and they get it, they've lost their guitarist, so they get a guitarist and it was me. And because I'm a kid, they have to clean themselves up. So it's more like you shouldn't take drugs sort of thing, moral.
Signs are that Nathan Cavaleri will move increasingly further away from Radio Lollipop and the Starlight Express Room.
Nathan, would you...
Today, though, his very presence, his matter-of-fact approach, and the fact that he's a cool kid will be especially remembered by more than a few parents who need to see there is a future.
Thanks, mate. You're going to go a long way.
Campbell Travers reporting. By the way, Nathan's new album, Jamming with the Cats, is about to hit the streets.